Well, it's the game Rutgers football fans have been waiting for, their Big Ten inaugural conference game against that team from Pennsylvania. And a lot has been happening this week, and there's much to talk about. Here to do just that, we are joined by Tom Luicci. Thank you, Tom. Now, you've seen this team through the spring and preseason and these first couple of weeks. What is it about the character of this team that makes you think they can win this game?
I think they have excellent frontline talent. I think that's something that gets overlooked sometimes with Rutgers. But when you look at the frontline talent, I think it's very, very solid. Secondly, I think they have excellent leadership. And thirdly, I think because it's a little bit more veteran team on the offense and at key points of the defense, they're going to be able to handle this big crowd, this big atmosphere. It's really going to be electric in the stadium. People have asked me, can I compare it to anything? And I would probably say Louisville in 2006. That may have been a little bigger because it was the first one, Taryn, but this one is probably going to match that in terms of electricity.
And, of course, there's been so much talk about Christian Hackenberg. What does the Scarlet Knights defense need to do to stop him?
I think they need to pressure him. I think they need to get him out of his rhythm a little bit because when he gets into a rhythm, he's a high-percentage passer. He's very accurate. He knows the offense very well. Several Rutgers defensive players have told me that. He knows exactly where the ball's supposed to go, and he can deliver it there. So if they can get him disrupted a little bit, get him out of his rhythm, Penn State, as we've seen on paper, doesn't have a great running game. So if they can make Penn State a little more one-dimensional, even though Hackenberg is very, very good, I think he's passing for about 386 yards a game. If they can make them more one-dimensional, maybe get pressure on Hackenberg, they have a chance.
And on the flip side of things, what do the Knights need to do to get in the end zone and put points up on the board themselves?
They probably need to run the ball effectively, something they didn't do well against Howard, to be honest with you. In spurts, they did. They need to run the ball effectively against a defense that has been very, very good against the run. I'm not sure that the run offenses that Penn State has faced so far have been as good as Rutgers, as Paul James, and now that Goodwin's back on offense and with Desmond Peoples. But run the ball effectively, because it just seems like when Rutgers does run the ball, everything else falls into place. The thing I'm most curious about, Taryn, is this is the first big game we get to see Ralph Friedgen kind of match wits with a defensive coordinator from another Big Ten school. And I think that's part of the intrigue of this whole game.
Well, thank you so much, Tom. Again, that game will be at High Point Solutions Stadium at 8 o'clock. And if you didn't get a ticket, don't worry. It will also be on Big Ten Network. No matter where you watch, though, keep an eye out before the game for two very special honorary captains. Representing the Nittany Lions will be Adam Taliaferro. And representing the Knights, of course, will be Eric LeGrand. From the Rutgers Practice Facility with Tom Luicci, I'm Taryn Hatcher.